Hi YouTube, it's me Elle coming at you today with my perm day. Yes, today is that day for me to get perm, a long overdue perm. I've tried to stretch it out for like 6 weeks. I think it's been 6 weeks. And boy, it is time. I couldn't wait no longer. I couldn't hold out. I couldn't even hold out till tonight. My head was itching up a storm. You know how your head knows when it's that time that you have to get a perm and it goes to itching? And you know we can't scratch. So I greased it up this morning. I'm like, let me hold out a little while. So yeah, I gotta do it right now, like ASAP. I am using a perm, dry hair, sensitive scalp perm. And it's pretty good. My first time using it was last month. It straightened the heck out of my hair. And I have my applicator brush, that's all I need. I've already prepped my hair. I've put Vaseline petroleum jelly around my hairline. And I've greased my scalp, like I said earlier, because it was itching up a storm, to protect my hairline. And that's it. I parted my hair down the middle and across, because I start not in the crown, but I start a little past the crown, because if you keep putting a perm on the same area, that weakens that area of the hair. So I try to find a different starting point every month just to move it around. So I'm starting a little past my crown, and I'm going to start back there with that. And I put a little dip on the applicator brush, and it's already been parted, so I'm just going to feeling my way through. And I have a mirror in the back of me, so I don't know if you can see it or not, but yeah, I'm putting my hair down also. And I part it, and I move to the next section. Try to move as fast as I possibly can, because, you know, you don't want that, you don't want to start burning, and you ain't even covered half of your head. I try to move fast, try to get this done in under like 20 minutes. I'm not going to go all the way down to my nape area, which is also known as the kitchen, because that's a very sensitive area too. It burns easily, and I haven't even covered half my head. So if I go to my kitchen before I even went to the front of my head, I'm going to have a problem. So I'm going to stop just shy before there. Just shy before there, and I'll come back for that. That'll be my last area, because I'm a kitchen burn. Did that sound right? And I'm moving to the other side and applying strokes going downward. And I'm feeling for that part. Feeling for the part in the middle. Partners on this way. I need to give a little less time on that. Let me see if I can get it. Like I said in the beginning of the video, this is my perm day. I just want to show people how I put in my perm. Everybody has a different method, especially if you've been doing it for years. I've been putting my own perms on for years. Even when I was going to the hairdresser, I would do my own perm and then just go get my hair done, because it's very costly, as you know, to get a perm these days at a salon, for something that you could virtually do yourself with the know-how. And this is my perm day. getting a perm. Going parting ends and pushing it up. Don't put any perm on the ends. I try not to put perm on the ends of my hair. I've always been taught that is not what you want to do if you want your hair. Sometimes you can't help it. It does, you know, go on there, but you know, don't make that a habit. Don't do it purposely. And I'm stopping short of my kitchen. Like I said, I don't want to go to my kitchen. And I'm going to unclip this front part of my hair and about to get inside of that. You see, I have all this. It is done back here, so I'm pushing that back. And I'm about to sew on my front. When I first got the perm, I didn't know if it was going to be enough for me because I'm so used to getting, you know, the big, you know, kits. And I was like, oh my goodness, this is not going to be enough perm in this thing to have all this big old head. But it was. It was. And what you do is you part and you put some on. I'm not getting a good shot yet. You put some on this side, you put some on this side, and I part it on up. And I throw this back. And I brush it back to smooth it out also, so I don't have to smooth nothing but the front out at the end. And that's what I'm doing. That's what the brush really does. Get it all in. Push that to the back. And move on to the next section. I try to make my little squares or parts very thin. Damn it. Got a little bit on it and don't sweat it. Just let it. Okay. And like I did with the kitchen part, I'm not going to go all the way to the front of my hair because that burns easily too. Real easy on me. Oh my gosh, my head be on fire sometimes with different perms. But this one has really, really, really lived up to its fame and its name because I've heard a lot of people say good things about a perm and what's that other one? Mazami. And they had that at the beauty supply, but I didn't mess with it. I want to stick with something I knew. And changing perms every month is not good for your hair. Stick to one little line. And this will be it with my front until I get to the other side and I can work the. Because I don't want to get too deep in here. Stop burning before I even get the other side half of my head. So yeah, that's it. This is it for this so far right now. So I'll leave that out. And now I'm taking the clip off of my left side and I'm gonna start with this. Start what I did on the other side. I'm gonna kind of feel my way what I've done back here. Make sure I get this. I don't want any dead spots. You know, how you put a perm in and after you finish, you feel some new growth still up in there. Ooh, I hate that. Like, oh man, I missed the spot. Okay, now. Parting here. This is the much bigger, thicker side, so I can't go all the way down, so I'm gonna have to break it up again and get on that. Break it on down and just roll down with it. Oh, this is hard work. But it's worth it. Save yourself 60, 70 bucks from going to the salon. The firm perm in my area is $9.99 at the beauty supply store, so that's good. That's a good.